Hello and a very warm welcome to Saurav Sir's classes. In today's tutorial, we will actually solve the IIT GEM 2017 paper on chemistry. We have already solved in our previous video till question number 8. So the first question of today's tutorial will be question number 9. The question says that the number of degrees of freedom of liquid water in equilibrium with ice is, we have 4 options. Now before going into that, let me give you a small or brief introduction. Now, on a little bit of brush up on the concept, when liquid water presents in equilibrium with ice, then the degree of freedom may be calculated using a formula. Okay, and this formula is written as P plus F is equal to C plus 2. Now you must be wondering that yes, you have learned something like this. Now let me denote what are the different notations use, what they are called. Now here I have used the notation P, which is nothing but the number of phases. F, as clear as crystal, it is degrees of freedom, and C is nothing but our number of components. What we are doing is that water and ice. Okay, now here P, that is number of phases, is 2, and the number of component is 1. We need to calculate F. Using the formula, we will do it. So, F becomes C plus 2 minus P, okay, using this formula. So, let us substitute the values quickly. 1 plus 2 minus 2. Degree of freedom becomes 1. That means B will be the correct answer to this particular question. Next, we move on to question number 10. Now, question number 10 says a straight line having a slope of minus delta U naught by R is obtained in a plot between what? Okay. So, for this, I require some space. So, now it was given to us that K subscript C is equal to AE to the power minus delta U naught by R. So it is by T, RT. Now let me take a log transformation so it becomes a little easy. So natural log KC is equal to natural log A minus, it is E to the power something, so minus U naught by RT. Now, if you calculate using the differentiation, you can calculate the slope. So, slope becomes minus U naught by R, and this with a negative sign indicate a negative slope. So, negative slope. So, diagrammatically, how you will portray this? So, it becomes 1 by T, I am measuring on the R horizontal axis, and on the vertical axis it is log KC. So it is a downward slope, negatively sloped. So M slope is equal to minus U naught by R, isn't it? So the given the diagram we have drawn, we can say clearly that for a negatively sloped, we must have log KC on the vertical axis and 1 by T on the horizontal axis. That means D will be the correct answer to this particular question. I hope this short tutorial on chemistry was helpful to you guys. Come back, because in our next tutorial we'll start with section B, with that is of 2 marks question. If our tutorials are helpful, then please hit the like button, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and share our videos with your friends and family, and thank you so much for watching.